All right, so we're going to write this lovely recurrence as a summation. And if you've seen some of the other videos, we actually do this. We look at the same problem and we attack it a different way. But this is another way to do it. And we're going to end up with the same answer. It's going to be crazy. All right, t sub naught is equal to 3. All right, so if we're going to write this as a summation, the first step we're going to want to do is we're going to find s sub n. We know that s sub n is going to be equal to a sub n minus 1 times a sub n minus 2 all the way down to a sub naught over b sub n minus 1 all the way down to b sub 1. All right? So a sub n is going to be that coefficient in front of the tn term, which is right now just 1. Or not right now just 1. It's always 1. So we have 1. And on the bottom, we have 2. Now, we have n of these on the bottom, so that means it's 1 to the 2n. So we're going to multiply that whole equation by 1 over 2n. So we've got 1, or t sub n, over 2n. Math, 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 because math is for winners! Plus this giant ugliness, which is wonderful. 2 to the n. Alright. If I simplify this, I've got t sub n over 2 to the n, t sub n minus 1 over 2 to the n minus 1, and that's when we get excited, right? Why are we excited? I totally don't know what we're doing. No, we're super excited because check this out. Because basically what we have here is the same thing that we have here, except everywhere we had an n, we now have an n minus 1, which means we can do this amazing thing, and we can let s sub n be equal to t sub n over 2 to the n, which means along the side that s sub n minus 1 is t sub n minus 1, over 2 to the n minus 1, and s sub naught is equal to t naught over 2 to the 0, so t naught is 3, and 2 to the 0 is 1, so it's just 3. All right, super, super amazing. All right, so that means I can rewrite this as I'm not going to write it in red, that's too angry and excited. S sub n is equal to s sub n minus 1 plus n squared plus 3 over 2 to the n. Awesome. So that means I can rewrite this as a summation now instead of writing as a recurrence of s sub naught k going from 1 to n k squared plus 3 over 2 to the k. Got it? All right. So s sub n is equal to 3 plus this crazy mess over 2 to the k. Now, believe it or not, there is actually a way to simplify this. Isn't that exciting? So one of the things I'm going to want to do is I'm going to actually want to separate this out. I'd like to go ahead and try to simplify it before I apply that t sub n thing back. So let's treat the 3 over 2k. So I'm going to do 3, 2 to the k, and then I'm going to do the k squared term separately. Because I happen to know that there are formulas out there that will work for each one of those two things. I've actually already known the first one, I put it in some other videos, but I'll rewrite it here for you guys as well. And I'll rewrite the other one, it's a little crazy though. Now, I know how much you love watching me do math, but all the same, I think I'm gonna go off to the side, do some scratch work, come back and simplify these terms here for you. But I just wanted you to know that they do have actual formulas that you can do on your own, because I mean, why wouldn't you? But rather than watch me do this for like the next 45 minutes, I figure I'll just pop the answers up for you. And there you go. Look how exciting that was. Now I can obviously do some simplifications here. Simplification for fun. 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 6 is 12. Right. 3 to the 2n. And then all this crazy. Alright, so now what I can do is I can come up here and I can remember that previously I determined that s sub n was equal to t sub n over 2 sub n, which means I can rewrite this that t sub n is equal to 2 to the n s sub n. So I can go ahead and apply that now. So t sub n is equal to 2 to the n s sub n. So if I plug that in there, I've got some pretty good stuff going on. Oh, man, the stuff isn't canceling out because I'm an idiot. I dropped my negative sign. See, this is why I don't have you guys, like, actually, you know, watch me do this math. It's actually quite terrifying. All right, this goes like this. Much better. Now things are gonna do what I want them to do. All right. So, So whenever I multiply by 2 to the n, I got minus 3. Oh, 12 times 2 to the n. minus 3 minus n squared plus 4 sub n plus 6. And then in one dramatic effect gets me this beautiful equation, which I actually knew already, but at least I've done it again a totally different way. So this is really exciting because basically now I have this method where even if I can't figure out how to write a recurrence with a repertoire method, I can now attempt to use a summation and see if I can get an answer there.